In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent and the Most Merciful. Assalamu alaikum. I am Alina Zaman Khan from Biomedical Department of University of Engineering and Technology, Taxila, and affiliated with the research group known as Syndicate of Embedded and Electronic Design. I am here to present my research work titled as Intelligent System for Classification of Pulmonary Diseases from Lung Sound. Among other authors are Engineer Zohaib Hassan Naqvi, Dr. Muhammad Ahmed Chaudhry, and Maheen Shakil. Here is the basic outline of what I am going to present. My motivation to work on this research, introduction and discussion about my research and its comparison with previous research works. Firstly, I am going to discuss my motivation behind this research. According to the survey conducted by World Health Organization in 2016, lung diseases are projected to cause 1 in 5 deaths worldwide. And out of top 10 most fatal diseases, 4 of them are related to lungs, among which chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases are the third major cause of death worldwide. And overall mortality rate associated with the respiratory diseases is round about 15%, among which COPD plays a major role. And almost 10% population is suffering from chronic asthma in our beloved country Pakistan, which shows that our field of medicine needs a lot of advancement for early diagnosis and for better treatment to save these precious lives. Now moving towards the introduction, we will discuss about the pulmonary diseases upon which my research is centered and breathing sound analysis. As I discussed before, what a major health issue these lung diseases are, among which chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases and asthma are the most prominent. And my research is particularly focusing on asthma and bronchitis, which is a type of COPD. Talking about the asthma causes 250,000 deaths worldwide. It's a large number. It's an allergic kind of disease which causes swelling, extra mucus production in the bronchioles, which leads to the triggered coughing, shortness of breath, and generate wheezing sound during respiration. And it can be further categorized according to the different triggers. Now let's talk about the bronchitis, which is a type of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. 65 million people are suffering from it and 3 million die each year. It is basically the inflammation in air channel causing chest tightness, cough, fever, so and so, and it can be further classified as acute and chronic bronchitis. Now from looking into the symptoms of these diseases, we can see the different sounds can be heard in their breath, and that's my major focus, to record these breathing sounds, analyze it and detect what the disease is from which the patient is suffering. No incision, no radiation, no auscultation, nothing. And to achieve this goal, I studied previous research work in this domain, some of which I would like to mention. In 2016, Naves work on the auscultated lung sounds and used KNN and knife base, achieving up to 94% to 98% accuracy. In 2017, Ulukaya also worked on auscultated lung sounds and achieved 97% accuracy using decision trees, extreme machine learning, KNN and knife base. In 2018, Burdao achieved 95% accuracy using support vector machine, K-nearest neighbor, Gaussian mixture model and convoluted neural network. And in 2019, one of the research is on auscultated lung sound and the other is on lung CT scan, achieving up to 86% accuracy by lung sounds and 99.4% accuracy by CT scans, which is really good accuracy, but we are here trying to avoid the radiations. And the other thing that is noticeable here, that all these researchers used K-nearest neighbor method for classification, so we can assume that this is one of the best method to classify the lung diseases. And that's the major point I also used for the classification in my methodology. Talking about the methodology, now let's discuss it. Here are four main steps: data acquisition, pre-processing, feature extraction, and classification. For data acquisition, I used mic and mouthpiece to record the breathing sound by placing it near the nostrils. Yep, that's it. That's how simple it is. You just need a mic, a sound card, and an operating system, and you are good to go. Here is the visual representation of how we collect this data. There were 150 subjects, 50 asthma, 50 bronchitis, and 50 normal subjects, and I collected 10 samples from each subject, and each of this sample is 10 seconds long. Number of samples are asthma 655, bronchitis 353, normal 568. And that's how our signal looks like in the time domain and frequency domain of all three categories. Which we take to the next step, that is pre-processing. For pre-processing, I used empirical mode decomposition technique to denoise this raw signal. All low frequency IMFs are removed from the signal because lung sounds usually lie in the high frequency range from 400 to 2000 Hz. So the region of our interest lies in the first intrinsic mode function. So we took this first IMF for further processing, and that's how our signal looks like in after pre-processing in time domain and frequency domain. And as you can see in the time domain graph, the little waviness in the signal that was present before is now gone. Now we can take this signal to the next step, that is feature extraction. Here we need to find those particular features that can help us to better distinguish between the diseases, for which I selected 4 features from the pool of multiple features, that are standard deviation, peak to peak, root mean square, and Shannon energy. Now moving forward to the final step, that is classification, for which I used k nearest neighbor technique, because there are wide range of samples and it needs a flexible algorithm to classify it correctly. Because as we know that KNN is one of the simple and flexible method, and we can actually achieve the great results from it. Talking about the results, now let's discuss the outcome of all these research methods that we applied. Here are some combination of features that I used, among which STD, peak to peak RMS, and Shannon energy gives the highest result. These are the scatter plots, in which figure A shows the plot between peak to peak and STD, and figure B shows the plot between root mean square and Shannon energy. Here is the comparison in accuracies achieved by different classification methods like SVM, linear discriminant, and boosted trees, but the highest accuracy was achieved by K nearest neighbor technique. And these are the accuracies achieved by different KNN methods, among which fine KNN shows the best result, that is 99.3%. And this is the confusion matrix of our system, which shows that only 2% error was detected. It can be possible that maybe one of our normal subject was not that well, but still this is very small amount of error. Now if we compare our research work with the previous one, most of them have used lung sound by auscultating using electronic stethoscope and 14 channel data acquisition device from the back of the patient, whereas I used just a mic with 44,100 sampling frequency by placing it near the nose to record the breathing sounds. And as you can see, all of them have used more than one classifiers, and I use only one classifier, that is K nearest neighbor, and gets the highest accuracy of them all. But talking about the seventh number research that is done by Naman Gupta and his companions, they have achieved up to 99.4% accuracy, which is great. But the problem is that their system is a bit complex, and how we can ignore the CT scans, radiations, which are dangerous. And we are here trying to find some solution to avoid these hazardous X-rays as much as possible, because it causes cancer. So we can conclude from all this discussion that this is the new approach in the field of pulmonology, which is safe, literally the safest and the easiest, and you don't need any training to auscultate and find the correct point in the lungs where gurgles could be heard, and you don't need a complex 14 channel device and wrap the patient in wires, and there is no radiation, no need of electrode, no danger to human health at all. And this whole system gives really, really accurate results and automatically detect the pulmonary disorders. That's why it can revolutionize the medical diagnosis of lung diseases if it is taken towards the practical application, inshallah. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you everyone for listening. Now you may ask about any query if you have in the comment section.